Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. In this video, I am going to answer a question that I've been getting all the time lately, which is how I create my tutorials that you see on my YouTube channel. The ones that I have for Canvas, the ones that I have for online teaching, the ones where you see the picture in picture. I'm going to show you a behind the scenes look at a video that I'm actually editing right now that I recorded before this video right here. So I'm going to take you behind the scenes and I'm going to show you how I record my videos and then make them look what you see when I post it on YouTube. If you haven't done so yet, don't forget to hit the subscribe button, turn on the bell notification so you don't miss any more videos. I've got some really exciting ones coming up in the months ahead. So the very first thing I do is I record the footage. Now, the camera that I'm looking at right now on my right is very different than the camera in my computer. I use both. The camera that you see that I'm looking at right now I have is the Canon Mark III. I will link it in the description box below for you, but I always have this set up to my right and I actually leave it set up there for all of my tutorials so I can easily record it. The sound that I use is from the Fifine microphone that I always have right above me, and I'm actually recording this through Filmora 9, which is the program that I use to edit, and I'm going to take you inside Filmora in just a second. So right now I have my Canon recording just the video of me, and then I have Filmora right now recording my computer screen, recording my picture in picture, and also recording my sound at the same time in one program. So after I finish recording, all I have to do is take the video from the Canon and then import it into Filmora, and I can start lining those up and creating the magic tutorials that you see here on YouTube. So the first thing I do after I hit record on the Canon and I turn on the record on my computer, the first thing I do is three claps. That way, when I go to link them together, I can easily line up the claps on the videos so it quickly syncs them up and I don't have to do a lot of other work. That's the first tip that I have for you. That makes it faster and easier when you want to go into editing anything. Okay, so this is a normal editing day for me where I don't have to really be on camera, so this is a totally behind the scenes look. All right, so I'm actually recording this in QuickTime right now. I will show you how I do this at a later date, but this is how I actually edit my content. So I use Filmora 9, which is part of Wondershare. Okay, so I opened a new project in Filmora. The first thing I'm going to do, and this is what I do before I actually record. So I go up here to the top, I click record PC screen. Okay, it pops down, it pops up over here. I turn my microphone on, I make sure that it's the one I want. I turn my audio on, and then I pick the screen that I want, and then I go down here to settings, and this is where I get the pick and pick that you like so much, is I click record camera simultaneously, and it pops the picture. You can see right over there on the bottom corner, and then I can move it wherever I want. I can also make it bigger or smaller depending on my needs. So this is how I record. So I set this up over here, on the side. I'll make this a little bit bigger so it covers the other picture in picture up. So I set this up and I have this running and I have my microphone on that's already attached to my computer. I hit record and then it is going to automatically start recording my screen, my picture in picture on the bottom. Here it is. It's going to record the picture in picture on the screen, and it's also recording my audio at the same time and anything I want in the computer. So when I turn to the right over here, this is the footage that I'm going to be laying on. So I turn to the right, I look at my camera that I have hit record on as well over on the side, and then I look back and forth and I do the whole thing at one go. So I have two cameras going, but when I'm done with this one, I finish recording the tutorial, I hit stop record. So then it pops up directly here into Filmora. All right. So you can see it's uploading and it has the audio and then it has the recording of my screen at the same time. So it's like two in one. What I'm doing right now is recording with QuickTime, and I'll show you how to do that in another video. But so many people were asking, I wanted to show you exactly what I do. So the next thing that I do is I go up here to import and I import the files that I want. Now the screen recording would already be in there because I already have that. Okay, so I've imported the other file, this one over here to the top left. This is the one from the camera on the right that you see, and this was the screen recording that automatically popped in. So what I do is I drop both of them down here. This was the side camera. I also want to drop down here the screen recording. So both of them are down here. I have them on top and bottom. Now I'm gonna line them up. This is why I did the clap thing at the beginning, so I can easily see where each of them are. This is a video that I'm doing for my students so they learn how to use Zoom. So it's a pretty quick, easy video. Let me line up the claps. So I turned down the audio on the camera on my right because I don't want that audio. I want the audio right here, the one from the screencast. So I turned down that audio, and now I'm gonna go through and I'm gonna clip off all the beginning parts, and then I'm gonna go through and edit out what I don't need. That's the first thing I'm gonna do, edit out all the content, the weird breaks or the pauses or whatnot. I'm gonna go ahead and clip all of that out first off before I do anything else. Okay, so I have eliminated and deleted all of the blank spots for the parts that I don't want. So now I just have the raw footage. The next thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go in and I'm going to flip back and forth between when I'm looking at the screen on the right and when I'm looking at the camera tutorial, the PC screen recording. So I'm gonna go through and pull those out so they go to the top and then they show up. Okay, I took a quick lunch break. I'm back. I've gotta get this done here in like an hour because I have a lesson I need to prep for. So here we go. Okay, so now I'm just going back and forth and going to continue finish the editing regarding the video that I want to be on top. So I want to flip back and forth from. Okay, so I just finished editing all of the content. So I have the video on top. The next thing I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna go through and over here, when this pops up, you can see the background here. So what I'm gonna do is I am going to put in a black backdrop for all of those so that you don't see it. So you can see there's a black backdrop back here now so you don't see it and it makes it a little bit easier. So I'm gonna go ahead and go through and do all of those really quickly. Okay, so I finished with all the black. Now I'm gonna go through and I'm gonna make sure that there is nothing that I wanna cover for privacy settings like students' names or, for example, my account information in Zoom. I'm gonna go ahead and cover that really quickly. I know a lot of people see that I use emojis. I use the emojis from here in the Elements section. So there's all kinds of emojis and whatnot. I know they get kind of annoying. I haven't found an easier way just yet to do it, but that's kind of how I like to do it. So now that I've done that, I'm gonna go in and add all the last final elements. I'm going to add in intro music and exit music. I'm also going to add in any type of buttons I want, like subscribe buttons or anything else. I'm gonna go ahead and go in and add that in now. Okay, so I am saving the project. I have put in a few things that I wanted to. I put in the titles or the subscribe buttons or anything else that I wanted to put in here. And now I'm going to click export. I am going to export it to my desktop and then I will be ready to upload it. That's an overview of how I create my YouTube videos, my tutorials, and also tutorials for my classes. I hope this helps answer a lot of your questions, and I'll see you in the next video. All right, happy teaching.